Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you YouTubers out there. Yes, I'm still here. I do not know why, and I'm starting to enjoy the fact that I am still actually here. In a way, you know, a lot of people wonder why. Well, yeah, there's no war. It looks like it could be, but yeah. The whole point is, I want to just go and show you some stuff in regard to just some stuff that people have been commenting on and everything. But one of the comments actually was in regard to this, right? Where I made the comment that they've been planning 9/11 for a long while. God, you've only got to look at the number plates and the time 9/11 is mentioned in so many videos. It points something out. If you think that it's just a coincidence, you're either an idiot or part of the conspiracy. So, yeah, I'll just wanted to point that out. But now I want to, like, this is the Andromeda Galaxy. Now, some people have been sort of saying, well, okay, if we've been moved, why do we still have the same constellations? Well, one of my counterparts about 6 months ago, or not long after I left, made a video in regard to this subject. I made one similar in another reality, but I'm pretty sure it was another beard in this reality that made it, because I actually used this image in the video I remember making. And the whole thing is, right, if you're looking at a galaxy, right, and you see a star constellation, right, everybody thinks that, okay, well, the Pleiades and everything and all that we see in the sky are within our own galaxy. Well, I've got some really, really bad news for those of you that think that, right, because if the Pleiades was inside our galaxy, right, you'd be seeing that behind the Pleiades at all times. You would see that. Nothing but the mist cloud of our galaxy. Right? The Pleiades and all that are not in our galaxy. The Southern Cross is not in our galaxy. Right? They are outside. Sorry, that's from the... They are outside of our galaxy. And for those idiots, and I'm sorry, I've got to call them idiots, right, that think that, okay, well, oh, we've still got the same constellations in the sky. Well, if we were looking in the galaxy and they were in our galaxy, they're in that part of the galaxy. That's what you would see. You would not see the constellations, you would see the galaxy. Okay, and it's pretty easy to work it out, right? Now, yet you look outside of the galaxy. Okay, you've got a star here. I don't know what that one is, because I don't know what galaxy this one is. I've just grabbed this picture, and I'm just going to block them out for a minute. I don't really want those stars to be noticeable, but I want to use them in a second. Now, the whole point is, if those stars were within our own galaxy, that is what you would be seeing all the time. They would be backed by that, okay? Because where we are at the moment in the Orion Spur, right, you see that both sides of the galaxy. That is all around Earth, okay? And anybody that thinks differently, for God's sake, go and look at Google Earth and spin Google Earth. You'll see it surrounds us. So, but as I was saying, right, my counterpart made a similar video. Right, that's the Sagittarius arm. This is the Orion Spur inside here. So that's our sun, okay, and that's us at the moment. Right, now you got the Pleiades up here, and you got everything else up here. You got the Southern Cross. They're up out here, right? The stars and the constellations are outside of this. All right, they're not inside that section there. They're not. No friggin' way. And if you believe that, you're an idiot. I'm sorry, you are. But if you have common sense, basic common sense, you will know that the star systems and all the stars you see in the sky are these things out here. Right? They're the stars you see in the sky out here. They're not in here. Alright? So, now, why are they flipped? Right? Because some people say, oh, well, the Southern Cross is back to front. Okay, yes, it's back to front for a reason. Right? Now, Earth was originally, say that's the Orion Spur there. That's where we are now. Right? And say Earth was all the way out here on the Sagittal arm. Right? You get ripped across the galaxy like that, moved 80,000 light years. Whoops. I'm getting better at this. 80,000 light years, right? Across the galaxy to... Oops, sorry, got it back to front. So those from the Orion arm went one way, the Sagittal arm went the other, I suppose. Now, I've been both directions, but still have not returned to my home planet. Now, I'm going to go back to the Andromeda Galaxy in a moment. Now, this is apparently another galaxy, but I'm just using this. But it's supposedly similar to our Earth, our galaxy. Now, when you flip something from this direction to over here, right? So if you're looking at something that has a configuration like that, right, and you've got a star there, okay? Why isn't that working? Okay, hang on. Sorry. Say that's the Southern Cross. It's just an example. Now, if you're looking at from this direction, or this direction, looking at this direction, the extra star is on this side. But if you're looking from that direction, it's over here on the opposite side. So it's flipped. Right? So that is one of the clearest points that tells you that some of us have gone from one side of the galaxy to the other. Right? The stars are definitely different. We have a different version of Earth. I'll find it. And they're not there. Bear with me a moment, folks. Okay, friends and subscribers, something's going. Okay, sorry about that, folks. Just a bit of a hiccup with the recording. Okay, now this is the image my counterpart used. I had to go and find it. Now, I originally come from over here. I'm currently over here. Say, for instance, this is the Pleiades system there. Right, from here, I'd need an 11-inch telescope to look at the Pleiades. Yet here, I can see the Pleiades directly behind the Moon. Right? The Pleiades system is much larger here. Now, I'm just drawing the Moon here. I know I'm not too good at it. And the Pleiades, you can see the Pleiades like that. Behind the Moon. Bigger than the spread out behind the Moon when you're looking at it from that direction. Yet from here, the Pleiades looks like a little dot. And you need a telescope to see it to make it look like the Pleiades, right? Take the Moon out of it, say that's the blue cloud that goes with the Pleiades at the moment. You've got to understand that, yes, it's a difference, right? Now, I'm going to go to the other problem. Everybody's talking about my kids, right? My kids are missing. I'm the one that's missing. In the beginning, I thought my children were missing. I'm the one that was taken. So those idiots that have been commenting on my videos saying, oh, you seem to be the only one that's missing children. Right? I'm actually not, by the way. Actually, read some of the comments in the videos. You'll find lots of people in the similar situation They just don't make videos. I'm just gutsier than other people to go out and make the video. Now, the point is, my children, to me, at first, were missing because I couldn't find them, because in this reality, they just don't exist, right? Because I was taken, because my home world is over here. Now I'm over here where only two existed, where here five existed. So is that simple enough math for you and a simple enough explanation? I'm the one that's missing, not my children. At first, yes, I thought it was my children. When you come into a situation where you can't find your children, yes, you're going to naturally think they're missing. You're going to do all the research. You're going to spend $11,000 on private investigators looking for your children, only to find out they just weren't born here. When I was looking for them, people started to think I was a bit batty, because all of a sudden they're telling me you didn't have that many children, right? The records show I only had two. And that's when I knew something was up, okay? And that's when I really knew this Mandela effect was real, right? Because my reality is not this reality. My reality lays over here, right? In some dimension, which dimension I don't know, because there are multiple dimensions, and trust me, I've seen them, and many of you have seen them. You're seeing them every time you see a change in the a Mandela effect. Every time you spot a Mandela effect, you are the one that has shifted reality. No one is going back in time, right? And I'll tell you why no one's going back in time. Because someone going back in time is not going to be able to change the landmass. Okay? And those idiots out there saying, oh no, but it's time travel. I'm sorry, but you're fucking 18 months behind us. We thought of that 18 months ago. Yes, we thought it too. We thought we were dead. Some of us still think we're dead. And occasionally that thought goes through my head like all the others. But you've got to realise that we're all victims. And we come from multiple dimensions, because many of us come from so, our worlds are so different that it's beyond a joke. There is a small percentage of people out there making videos, yes. A small percentage of them out there, i.e. the ones making the comments, because they think that their videos about the time travel are more important. You need to wake the fuck up. You really do. You make a comment on mine. That's why you're blocked on my channel, by the way. Because you come on my channel and you say, well, okay, this is that, that is that. I don't come on your channel and say, wake the fuck up. I tell you in my own video to wake the fuck up. I don't name you. I don't shame you. I just make you wake up, okay? And that's all I'm trying to do. I'm trying to make you realize that you are the one that is physically shifting, okay? Why we are shifting, no one fucking knows. There is not a person amongst the Mandela community that has worked this out yet. But what we do know is we are changing reality. We have a new heaven and a new earth, as promised in the Bible. Maybe this is religious, yes. Maybe this is the great tribulation that God promised us. But for anybody that thinks someone can go back in time and move a continent thousands of miles, you're nuts. You're the one that is nuts. And I'm going to call you nuts. Right? Because they can't move the continent. I thought they were changing maps. Right? At least when I thought it, I just thought it was a map change. Right, but to physically move a continent, to physically move a harbour, in my area, harbours, and I've seen changes to that harbour so many times. But what you've got to realise is that everybody comes from a different world. For some unknown reason, we are all affected. Why is it a selected amount of people that know about the Mandela effect. Now, you say, okay, why am I the only one that is experiencing missing children, okay? But you've got to realise, they're not missing. I'm the one that is missing. Me. I'm the one that was taken. Took me a while to realise it, but I'm the one that was taken from my home fucking world. But you all need to fucking realise this. If you don't, you're lost. And you'll be a victim and a slave. Because I've got a funny feeling this is all about slavery. I think they're preparing us for something. We've been kidnapped. Select amount of people have been moved around and tested and shuffled around and everything like that. As I said, if God's involved, yeah, he sent me to hell for a little while to make me wake up. And it did. It did make me wake up. And trust me, that is always in the back of my mind, that maybe I got sent to hell and went to V3 because this is the tribulation and God was waking me up. So you all need to realise, the Mandela effect is real. It has affected people from all over this galaxy. And maybe, now, this is where I said I was going to call up the Andromeda Galaxy again. Right? Because maybe, right, you look at the Andromeda Galaxy. There we go. The Andromeda Galaxy. There. That's the Andromeda Galaxy. Look at it. Looks very fucking similar to ours. That's most probably why they've always said that there's another Earth. Maybe there's another Earth in the Andromeda Galaxy. Well, guess what? I believe there is. Maybe we are the Andromeda Galaxy to that galaxy. Okay? Now, you think about it. Maybe my Earth or your Earth is actually here in the Andromeda Galaxy, and someone else is in the Andromeda Galaxy, and maybe someone else comes from this little galaxy down here. Did you ever think about that? Maybe when God made all of us, he separated us. All right, and then, okay, well, I'm going to address the Big Bang theorists as well. Maybe in the Big Bang, all the atoms were so similar that Earths developed in every single galaxy in multiple places within the galaxy because the atoms were so similar. Did you ever think about that? So those of you out there questioning the Mandela effect and the logic of the Mandela effect and everything like that, you need to start waking up. It's real. It's happening to everybody. Everybody's got a different story. My children are not missing. Right? I can't go back into that video and fix it because they don't put annotations. They've stopped me. I can look at the annotations and delete them, but I can't put new ones in there to tell you my kids aren't missing. It's me that's missing. Okay, because YouTube stopped that, remember, so I can't fix that. Right? I haven't been here for 12 months. Right? I come back and find out YouTube's changed. So you all need to wake up. And for those people just watching the one video or that watch this video and say, oh, well, there, well, this part's that and all this. Guess what? There's a couple of hundred other videos not just made by me but by other Bluebeards that are travelling the verse as well. Many of us are travelling it. The reason why we know we're travelling it is because we keep a journal. We keep track of what we're doing. We keep track of the changes. We make sure that we keep track of all the changes. And those of you out there that aren't tracking the changes, I'm sorry, but you're the ones that are being fooled. You're fooling yourself. And that's the bad thing. Because the longer you fool yourself, you're never going to know where you are. You're never going to know what reality you're in. Right? The only reason I know I'm back in this reality because I wrote a letter. And I found that letter. I found someone making a video about that letter. Actually, that's how I found out I was actually back, because I watched the video of them talking about my letter. And I realised I'm fucking back in this reality. This is the first reality I came aware of the Mandela effect. I may have been to others prior, but they were so similar that I didn't notice them. And in fact, it was quite a few realities, I believe. And it's only after a while I realized, yeah, well, that was different, that was different, that was different. Oh God, I've shifted a few times. Then I went to V3, and then I really knew that I had shifted. That was the awakening. That was the true awakening for me. And people say, oh, well, you're not as cut up about it. Well, guess what? That was over 12 months ago. I've had time to recover. Some of the beards that have been here haven't said a thing, haven't put out a video. That's all the blank spots in this channel, because they're the ones that have been traumatized. And trust me, I didn't make videos in the reality I went to after V3 either. I was traumatized. But I've had time to recover. And you all need to realize that. So something you're seeing in my videos, right, or the Bluebeard videos, aren't just myself. They are other Bluebeards from other realities that are caught up in this Mandela effect. Right? And the only reason we know that we're different is because we're seeing each other and looking at each other and keeping the journal. And that journal is private between us. It tells us when we've got to go to the doctors, or when we've got an appointment here, or when we've got an appointment up at the hot, like here, or got to go and see mum, or you got to go and see this. Because I can tell you now, if you're not keeping a journal and you're shifting around, people are going to think you're forgetful, because you've made plans and, oh sorry, you didn't make plans, one or the other, you made plans, and you think about it, how many times have people said to you, oh, you didn't show up for this, and said, oh no, you didn't organise that with me. Well, guess what, they did. They organised it with another you, but because you aren't keeping journals, you don't know about it. Right? Some people aren't shifting as much as others. Yes, I know. I do not know why. If I knew why, I'd be able to solve this fucking problem. Right? No one knows. So you've all got to wake the fuck up. If you're just coming on to troll, yeah, well, guess what? The trolls, your comments don't make it to the channel. So the rest of you out there that are Mandela affected, and you don't understand why and how and everything like that, please understand, it is not my children that is missing. It is me that is missing from my reality. That video was made over a year ago, back when I first discovered that I couldn't find my children. That was when I made the first realization that I had shifted. I had been moved. I'd been ripped across the galaxy. So you've got to understand, if you've only watched that one video and this video, go back and watch all the couple of hundreds. You'll see a progression of Bluebeards coming to this reality. And if you don't see that progression of Bluebeards, you're all fucking nuts. I'm sorry, you really are. And I've got to say it, if you think that it's just logos, you've got to wake up. For God's sake, it's not just logos. I'm not ripping one particular person out here. I'm ripping a lot of yous. Because you've all got to realize this is really fucking happening. The Bible has changed because we're in a different reality. It was written differently here, guys. It was written differently. Yes, it could be the Great Tribulation. I do realize that. But in this reality, and it is a different reality, there's too many changes from my world to tell me this is not my home world. And that's what I know. But it's not my kids that are missing, it's me. I am the equation that's not there anymore. Or I might still be there, but it's maybe not me. In one of the realities, one of the beards got to go home to his reality, and they said that they were called the Raptured. Yes, I watched that video too. And you've got to understand that, okay, well, what's going on? He was most probably the first one back there, so where's the rest of the people? So you've all got to understand, everything is different for everybody. I'm still waiting to go home. I'd love to go home. But until I know what's going on, who's causing this, because I'm pleading to whoever who's causing this to undo what you've done and send us all home so we all can go back to our own realities, so we can go back to our families. Yeah, my world was war-torn, but it was my world. It's where I come from. Yes, I want to see my children. And that's all I want. I want to go home. Yes, I'm enjoying jumping around because I'm seeing things that no one else can dream of. Maybe this is why, because I've actually, how would you say it? I have actually not just accepted the fact that I'm moving around, I'm researching it. And I'm not looking at everything in a negative tone of the Mandela effect. Maybe that's why they keep on moving me so much. Maybe that's why I wound up in V3, because of my mind and what I do. Maybe I did go to hell. I don't know. I really don't fucking know. But that's what you've all got to understand. Do you know what the fucking Mandela effect's about? Because if you do, tell fucking me. I'd love to fucking know. So stop trolling on my channel. Go out there, watch all my videos, and just don't make comment on fucking one. Go and watch the fucking videos and you will see a progression. I've been in this reality for about 3-something weeks. Right? I was here for a while when I was first here, I think. But I moved and got shuffled around after that and spent a year away from this fucking planet and this reality and seeing things that I could have never imagined. But I've seen them, I've experienced them. Some of them weren't good, some of them were. But you've got to understand that until we know what the fuck is going on, no one knows what the fuck is going on. And that's what I mean. No one knows. Anybody that says, oh, I know what's going on, I got an idiot saying out there, oh, it caused the Mandela effect. Yeah, they're the real idiots. But the whole point is, folks, you've all got to understand that we are shifting. We are moving. We are being manipulated. Because I know for a fact there are scars on my body that I've sustained in other realities. And they're still on my body. And the other beings have experienced the same. But we are being physically manipulated. Are we all being shuffled from world to world to world to world? Are we meeting occasionally and meeting the same people or talking to the same people that we've talked to in other realities and they just don't fucking know it yet? I believe that is a major possibility. So those of you out there that don't know what the Mandela effect is, well, look into it. It is not just logos. It is people being shifted and kidnapped from one side of the galaxy. For me, it was over here. I was on the outside of the galaxy. Right, but now, I'm in here somewhere. Oh, sorry, maybe in here somewhere. Right. So I've gone from here all the way over to here. Right, where the Pleiades I needed to look through a giant fucking telescope to see it. We're here, I can see it with the naked fucking eye. So you tell me what the fuck's going on, okay? I'm out of here. Bye. Oh, bye.